Hello everyone, my name is Balaji. In this video, you will learn Splunk components. Let's look at two main Splunk software packages which are used mainly in Splunk deployment. First one is Splunk Universal Forwarder, second one is Splunk Enterprise. Splunk Enterprise software package can be set up to perform any of the roles which I'll explain here. Heavy forwarder, indexer, search head, deployment server, cluster master, license master, deployer. Before understanding Splunk Enterprise different roles, first let's understand what is Splunk Universal Forwarder. Splunk Universal Forwarder, in short, we call it as Splunk UF. Splunk UF is a separate software package. It is free to download. License is not required. We install Splunk Universal Forwarder on servers or endpoints from where we want to collect events. Let's understand few examples of Universal Forwarder usage. First example is, you have a file which is continuously getting updated with new events. You want to collect events as soon as the file is updated with new events. Another example is, you want to monitor NTP service to check whether the server is syncing with your company NTP server or not. You can write a script, add it to an application. The application can be deployed to Universal Forwarder installed on the server. UF can be managed by deployment server. I'll explain what is deployment server in this video later. As I mentioned earlier, application can be deployed to Universal Forwarder. The application deployment is possible by deployment server. UF cannot parse events. Let's understand what is event parsing. While UF reads the data stream from its source, breaks into 64K blocks. Breaking the stream of data into individual lines is one of the features of event parsing. Identifying timestamp of each event happens at the time of parsing only. Timestamp is crucial for each event in Splunk because events are indexed with their timestamps. Adding meta fields, source, source type, and host to each event happens at the time of event parsing only. UF is not capable of parsing events, but heavy forwarder is capable. UF cannot apply filters to remove unwanted events. For example, you have a file to read events from. You don't want to index certain events based on some keyword criteria. This is not possible with UF. Having said that, it can apply filters on Windows events. Splunk Heavy Forwarder is one of the roles of Splunk Enterprise package. To have Heavy Forwarder in your deployment, you should download Splunk Enterprise only and then configure Splunk Enterprise to act as Heavy Forwarder. Splunk HF is an optional component because HF role can be added to an indexer if Splunk deployment is very small where not much data is indexed per day. But as a Splunk consultant, I recommend heavy forwarders to offload indexer's workload. HF can be managed by deployment server. Updating or creating new configurations or applications on heavy forwarder can be done by deployment server. HF can parse events. I have already discussed what is event parsing. Event parsing can be done by heavy forwarder or indexer if there is no HF. HF can apply filters to remove unwanted events. This will save Splunk license. Filtering of events cannot be done by Universal Forwarder, but HF can do the job. This will save Splunk license. Splunk license works based on how much volume of data we are indexing per day. Splunk Indexer is another role of Splunk Enterprise package. This is example Splunk architecture diagram where the architecture is set up with cluster master, search head, three indexers, two forwarders. Peer nodes highlighted in red color box are nothing but indexers. Splunk Indexer is mainly used to store events, indexes them, and serve requests of Splunk search head. If no HF, parsing and filtering of events will be done by indexer. This is the main reason I have mentioned Splunk Heavy Forwarder is an optional, but having no HF will overload indexer and reduce performance of Splunk search if it is not properly sized its CPU and memory. Indexers are also called search peers if they are part of indexer cluster. You can see in the diagram, indexers are called peer nodes because they are participating in indexer cluster. Indexers are managed by cluster master node if they are an indexer cluster. You can see red color double-sided arrow connecting master node and each peer node in the right side diagram. Splunk search head is another role of Splunk Enterprise package. Splunk users who are not Splunk admins mainly interact with Splunk search head. Splunk subset shows events that are stored in indexer when user runs query. Splunk subset is used to generate reports such as dashboards and also to create field aliases, calculated fields, lookups, event types, and tags. In Splunk terms, we call reports such as dashboards, fields, lookups, event types, tags, knowledge objects. Splunk Cluster Master is another role of Splunk Enterprise package. Splunk Cluster Master manages indexer cluster. You can see there are three indexers and replication factor is set to 3, which means when forwarder starts sending data to indexer, the data should be replicated in 3 indexers. Let's say there are 10 indexers. An indexer which is receiving data doesn't know that to which indexer replication copy of data should go. Instruction will be given to indexer by cluster master where to stream replica. In case of peer node failure, adjusting cluster buckets will also be done by cluster master. When user types something in search of search head and hits search button, search head will first contact cluster master to understand where the data exactly resides. Cluster master will instruct search head, for example, the data you are looking for is available in indexer 3 and 4, then search head will contact indexer 3 and 4 to fulfill user search request. Creating new index, applying props or trons will be done on cluster master and then they will be deployed to peer nodes. Unlike indexers, master node doesn't index data. Only one master node for one indexer cluster. Splunk Subset Deployer is another role of Splunk Enterprise package. Subset Deployer is used to deploy apps to subset members of subset cluster. Unlike we install apps on standalone subset directly, it's not recommended to install apps directly on such members in subset cluster. Splunk Deployment Server is another role of Splunk Enterprise package. You can see here in the picture, single deployment server below, and then server class and deployment clients. A Splunk Enterprise instance that acts as centralized configuration manager, it deploys configuration updates to other instances, also refers to the overall configuration update facility comprising deployment server, clients, and apps. What is deployment client? A remotely configured Splunk Universal forwarder or enterprise instance, it receives updates from the deployment server. What is deployment app? A unit of content deployed to the members of one or more server classes. What is server class? Server class is nothing but combination of deployment client and deployment app. For example, you have Windows TA which contains inputs to collect Windows event logs and you want to deploy this TA to all Windows servers. The new server class will combine TA which is basically deployment app and Windows servers which are basically deployment clients. The deployment client can belong to multiple server classes. Splunk License Master is another role of Splunk Enterprise package. License master controls one or more license slaves. What is license slave? The license master provides its slaves access to Splunk Enterprise licenses and, in the case of indexers, associated licensing volume. From the license master, we can define stacks, pools, and licensing capacity and manage license slaves. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe for more videos.